Hey everyone, today we're going to be reviewing SD Maid. It's like defragging your PC except for your Android. What's up everyone, thanks for tuning back in for another review. But before I start the review, I want to make a small announcement. Last night I reached 1,000 subscribers, and I wanted to thank all of you for supporting my channel. When I started The Smoking Android, I wanted to make a channel that appealed to both the advanced Android user and the average Android user. To accomplish this, I wanted to make videos about both Android hacking and modding, but also about useful apps and tools to make your Android experience just that much better. All the apps and reviews I do are on apps that I believe are actually useful, unlike most Android app videos. I believe I have accomplished this, otherwise I wouldn't have gotten this far, I suppose. So again, thank you all so much for your support. From the bottom of my heart, I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for all of you. Now, before I get all emotional, let's jump on into the review, shall we? Alright, so I was doing some ROM flashing the other day, and I was loading files onto my SD card, and I noticed that there were a lot of folders and files that were no longer relevant. I had either uninstalled apps or there was a buildup of useless files that were just sitting there dormant. I thought to myself, man, I wonder how many people out there have a massive buildup of useless and dormant files and folders on their phones taking up valuable memory. I wonder how many phones have been slowed down as a result and people just don't know why. Maybe if iPhone had an app available like this, people wouldn't be wondering why after a year of heavy use their phone slows down to a snail's pace. Well anyways, I started searching and came across this awesome tool. SD Maid is, as the developer describes it, a complete system cleaning tool. Now, keeping in mind root is recommended, but not totally necessary, and we'll get to that in a minute. So from the top, or I should say from the left, the app gives you a quick glance at gives you a quick glance of the different memory locations of the device to see how much is being used and where. Now, next we have the Explore tab. This reminds me of Root Explore because it lets you see everything, as well as edit and change permissions, which is a nice feature. Now, I'm not going to go over everything that this app can do because it does a lot. Instead, I'm going to go over the main function features that I believe would be useful to myself and all of you. So next is the Corpse Finder. Corpse Finder looks through your storage for folders that are dead and have no use or tie-in with anything else. This is really helpful for cleaning up all the files and folders that may have been taking up space on your phone, causing it to slow down. This is where I think it's sort of like defragging your computer, if you will. Next is Clean System. With this option, it removes and cleans files from your lost.dir folder, which many of you may not know, but those of you that do know, it's basically a folder where a lot of useless files get stored and so on. Clean System, it also cleans your cache, and it gets rid of empty gallery thumbnails and cleans log files that are unnecessary too, which is really helpful. Now, I mentioned before that root is and isn't necessary. there are some apps, some features of the app that you will only be able to use if you have a rooted phone. And moving on with that, there is a paid version and a free version, I believe. And the paid version, I think it's just a free version. And again, the difference between root and non-rooted phones, you'll notice when you download it. Anyways, moving on. Clean apps is the next feature, and it's a really neat feature at that. It lets you choose individual apps where you can clean the data and cache, I believe cache as well, but this is really helpful, for instance, if your market or any other app is acting strange. You could try to clean it up first with this feature before trying to, you know, uninstall it or leave some negative feedback on that particular app. Duplicates is the next feature. It's really awesome. This is where I think SD Maid really, really shows and really shines. It looks for duplicate apps, folders, and files that might be in your internal and external storage. Now, I found this feature very useful. Somehow, I always end up putting one file on the internal, forget about it, and then I end up putting the same file on my external. And that ends up over time adding up. And it's a real big pain in the ass to try and go between your internal and external to see which are which files you have duplicated, if any. And that can be really time consuming. So this does all that work for you. And the last feature I thought was really handy is the Miscellaneous tab. In here, you can quickly clear market history, view modified files, and something really useful, show the top 50 biggest files. This will tell the novice users what is preventing them from downloading more, well, useless apps. You know, the apps that are like 1.4 megabytes in size, and then you install it, and then it downloads an additional like 1.2 gigabytes. And then they go into the forums wondering why their phone is telling them that the file size is too large. Well, now they can figure it on their own. So yay for us advanced Android users for not having to tell the noobs the simple things in life like that. yeah. Anyways, that's it for this one. Thanks again, everyone, for subscribing and watching my videos. Your support and feedback means the world to me and makes me feel even more responsible for providing you all with quality content that you actually care to watch, because I know that there are a lot of useless Android-related videos out there, and I hope I've helped you all cut through all the crap. So as usual, leave me a comment below letting me know your thoughts, maybe even a little congratulations. and, you know, please give this video a thumbs up. I put a lot of work into it. And if you haven't already, make sure you subscribe for more videos like this one. Anyways, till next time, guys, the Smokin' Android signing out.